हेलो पीपल, वेलकम वन एंड ऑल टू जोजोस लर्निंग क्लब।
हेलो गाइस, आई एम बैक अगेन। सो दिस इज माय पार्ट 5 फॉर द अलजेब्रा एंड टुडे आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग ऑन डायरेक्ट एंड इनवर्स प्रोपोर्शन। As I've already promised in my previous videos that I'll be taking a separate section on direct and inverse proportion for your better understanding. So today I'll be dealing completely with direct and inverse proportion. So let's directly start. Let's take an expression first. So y is equal to 3x. So this is an expression, right? And you can see that whenever you give a value for x, there is a corresponding value for y. So you can say that x is here the independent variable, and y is dependent on x, right? So y is known as the dependent variable. So you can see that whenever there is an increase or decrease in the independent variable, there is also a corresponding decrease or increase in the dependent variable. So you can say it as direct proportion. For a direct proportion or for proportionality, sign is like this. So you can say that y is directly proportional to x, because whenever there is a change in x, whenever there is an increase or decrease in the value of x, there is a corresponding increase or decrease in the value of x. When y x increases, what happens? The value of y increases. When y value of x decreases, the value of y decreases. So this is what a direct proportion is. So direct proportion, now we can write as an expression as y is equal to kx. So where k is the coefficient of proportionality. So k is the coefficient of proportionality. So for this expression y is equal to 3x, what is the value of k? The value of k here is 3. So this is what about a direct proportion is. And then what would be inverse proportion? Inverse proportion is that when in an independent variable, when an increase in independent variable leads to a decrease in the dependent variable, or and decrease in the independent variable leads to an increase in the dependent variable, this is known as inverse proportion. So let's take it. So here, when inverse proportion is what it would be? It would be inverse, right? So you can write like this. So y is equal to k into 1 by x. So what is k? K is equal to xy. So this is all about direct and inverse proportion. It's really easy. And now let's do two more problems so you get a better understanding on the topic on direct and inverse proportion. So first let's read the question, the problem number A. So if y is directly proportional to x, and so it is said that in the problem what? The y is directly proportional to x. So we know that y is equal to kx. Y is equal to 2.4 and x is equal to 0.4. So the given conditions are y is equal to 2.4 and x is equal to 0.4. So why we have to determine the coefficient of proportionality. So the first problem inside that is the determine the coefficient of proportionality. So in this, to find the coefficient of proportionality, what you have to do? So k is equal to y by x. What's the value of y? 2.4 divided by 0.4. As I said, when you have a decimal in terms of fractions, what you have to do? Multiply it with tens values so that there are no decimal points inside it. So here both the place you saw one place after the decimal point. So you can multiply it with 10. When you multiply a number in the denominator, you have to be careful that you have to multiply that number in the numerator too. So you multiply here 10. So 24 by 4, and the value of k is 6. Now the value of y we have to find when the value of x is 0.7. So from this we know that formula is y is equal to k into x. The value of k already we have found, the coefficient of proportionality is 6 and the value of x is 0.7. So we need to find the value of y when the value of x is 0.7. So 6 into 0.7, which is nothing but 4.2. Very easy, right? So this is all about direct proportion. And now let's do another problem using inverse proportion, so you'll get an understanding on inverse proportion too. And the problem is, The electrical resistance of a piece of wire is inversely proportional to the cross-sectional area. So it is said that the resistance of a piece of wire is inversely proportional to the cross-sectional area, right? So it is similar to the formula y is proportional to 1 by x, right? So what you can say, r is equal to k into k by a or k. So k is equal to r into a. So the first problem would be to find the determine the coefficient of proportionality. It's very easy. What you have to do, you just have to multiply this value with the other value, 7.2 into 5. So 7.2 into 5, 7 to 5 is 10, 7 to 5 is 35, 360. So you can write it as 36 is the coefficient of proportionality for this problem. And the next problem, the second problem inside the problem number B, the cross-sectional area when the resistance is 4 ohms. So we need to find the cross-sectional area. What was the formula? K is equal to R into A. So what we have to find here? The cross-sectional area. So to find the cross-sectional area, it is K by R. So what it would be? K, we know that it is 36. And the value of resistance is already given, it is 4. So it is 9. What it was? Millimeter square. So here it is millimeter square. So this is the value for the problem number B second. So that's all about inverse and direct proportion. So for inverse proportion, it is such a way that whenever there is an increase in the independent variable, it leads to a decrease in the dependent variable, or vice versa. But in case of direct proportion, what it is, when there is an increase in the independent variable, it leads to an increase in the dependent variable. Whenever there is a decrease in independent variable, it leads to a decrease in the dependent variable. So this is all about direct and direct proportion, and see you on my next video. Bye bye.